upcoming union budget session likely to be a stormy one, as the demoralized opposition has something to fall back, if not regroup on the floors, thanks to the historic drubbing that got to the ruling Bharatiya Janata Party in the recent assembly elections. The lone question on everyone's mind is how any bills that BJP-led National Democratic Alliance can successfully push through. As many as 23 bills, which would be introduced in the session of Parliament, needs at least 4 of them to be cleared, and they are the coal mining, the land acquisition, insurance and minings and minerals, which had to be replaced by ordinance issued earlier. The NDA may have to brute majority in Lok Sabha, but the worry is of Rajya Sabha, where it has only 57 MPs out of total of 245. Narendra Modi's government hopes to get the support of the BJD's 7 MPs and AIADMK's 11. Yet, the problem remains unresolved, and the NDA floor managers, including Parliamentary Affairs Minister M. Venkaiah Naidu, also working hard holding parleys with several opposition members. If one has to believe news reports, he may even knock the doors of the Congress President Sonia Gandhi and take her party's support, especially in Rajya Sabha, to push through these bills. Pressure is also building up against, especially on the Land Acquisition Amendments Bill outside Parliament too. Anna Hazare is launching a two-day token agitation and has got an unlike ally, the Swabhimani Shetkari Sanghatna, which is part of the BJP-led alliance government in Maharashtra. The land ordinance removed the consent clause from the act, and now 80% of affected farmers would no longer be required to give their consent to acquire land for a private or government project involving national security, defense, rural infrastructure, industrial corridors, and housing for the poor. The coal mining bill, which would open mining to private companies, could also face opposition. Both Odisha and West Bengal will benefit. But then, the Trinamool Congress and the BJP are at loggerheads, and there is an assembly election in the near future in the state, where the BJP is increasingly becoming a key player. In other words, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi is well aware that this session is going to be crucial, not only for the growth story, but also for his image. It is also a test of the NDA's skill and depth of its engagement with the opposition, no matter how weak it may be at the moment. As a matter of fact, the PM has already launched a charm offensive recently. He made his position clear on religious freedom and reached out to Sharad Pawar in his pocket borough Baramati. The other day, Modi also attended the pre-wedding ceremony of Samajwadi Party chief Mulayam Singh Yadav's great-nephew, Manipuri MP Tej Pratap, in Sci-Fi. True, Mulayam and Modi are not great believers in the dictum that two's company. But as our recent visitor Barack Obama famously said, politics is a contact sport, and at the moment, the NDA needs to play that game, even if it means a few bruises to its ego. News Desk, Manga News.
Religious leaders representing every major world religions, Christianity, Hinduism, Judaism, Baha'i faith, Buddhism, Islam, Taoism, and indigenous religions met, discussed and pledged to uphold the Universal Declaration and of Freedom of Religion or Belief.